Hello, hello, hello. Hello, everybody. How are you all? One Drug Man, hello. Mr. Poggart. Nick Jimster, Smush Cat, Obsidian, Odin Lings, hello. Nine Walker, Zanira. Where am I? Who am I? Welcome, welcome. Busy Timmy, hello. Tactiles, thank you so much for the Prime Gaming sub. Thank you, thank you. Marksy, hello. Oh yeah, kind of forgot to post about it on Hiney's Discord. Maybe I'll do that. What board am I using? Exclamation keyboard for what I'm using right now. I think it should be corrected, so. I'm typing on a KFECE. Do you know how much a commission Jane costs? No. No, I don't know. Keyboard? No, keyboard, keyboard. All right. I got some mail today. I got some caps. I got these keycaps here. Some artisans. What is this? What was the internet? And I also got this thing. I got GMK Black Moddy. I already rebagged it into this novelties bag because the original trays are trash. But yeah. GMK Black Moddy. And I got these artisans today. Got these dollar tacos. Bolesks. Pretty nice, right? And then I got this Latrialum birch cap. Pretty cute. She revised her her bottom, like the stem and the bottom part. I noticed it's thicker now, which is good because that was kind of my main concern with her caps. They kind of, honestly, her older caps felt and sounded like shit, to be honest. Like they just were paper thin, the stems were kind of loose, they just kind of sounded very like just very light and kind of like very very different from like any other caps, so that always was kind of my concern. But she's revised the bottom, which pleases me a lot, so yeah, it's good to see it. Alright, so let's get started, shall we? Wanna trade lats? Sure, maybe? Alright, let's start with the small box first. So as you can see, keyboard model Num1 public buy gold and with a alu plate A stock. kind of bulky because it had this bag with I think the PCBs. How's school going? I've been losing all motivation lately. I can relate regarding motivation. I would say that I also have ups and downs in my motivation. I think it's going, like, today was actually not a bad day, but I kind of regained some motivation today after I had a meeting to like recap what I needed to do. But it goes up and down a lot. Yeah, that's the reality of it. Honestly, I can tell you that I don't always feel too motivated. Yeah, it's just what it is. So we have two PCBs here. I don't need to show the other one, but it's just a numpad PCB. Has support for split things where the 2U keys are. Pretty standard though. USB-C port. And let's open this guy up. STEM majors are just great? What do you mean? Is that a sarcastic comment? Anyway, let me read this earlier comment. Aftermarket Janes are like 7,000, I think. No way commission Janes should cost more than that. Probably not, no. I feel like Yutsi would not charge that much in the first place because he's a very nice guy. But, oh, also I realized that my command is misspelled, mounted. Well, like, Yutsi is a nice guy, right? And, but the reality is also that he's a very busy person. So he has collabs going on, he has his own projects going on, he has his job, he's only one person. He probably gets hundreds of DMs every day. So actually, even when, like, I kind of know him a little better, but like, even when I DM him, I normally don't get my response within like a month. So it takes almost a month for him to respond to anything, really. Unless it's urgent. If it's urgent, he'll respond. But almost all the time, he won't respond for like a month or longer. Ish. And that's like, we kind of know each other. And so even then, he takes about a month to reply. So yeah, he does not go through his DMs that much, I also think. I would like to think that he also ignores a lot of them because there's a lot of unsolicited things like, oh, can I have a DGR? I'll pay you whatever you want. And or like, I'm a big fan of your work. I have 4 million followers on TikTok. It's like, who cares, right? So yeah, there's a lot of that. UT standard response time, 6 weeks? Yeah. Yeah, oh, hey, what's up, dude? How you doing? Good to see you. 6 weeks sounds about right, though. Sometimes it's like 6 business weeks. Like 6 weeks in business days, like even longer. Alright, so we have our numpad. Oh, the bump ons are there. Okay, I guess they won't come out. But here is our numpad, first of all. Nice gold anodizing. This color is pretty sick, actually. I have to say that, if the FNF didn't have the lilac color, this color is 100% my second choice. This is really nice. Such a nice gold color. It's kind of like a, it's almost like a, you might think it's like a warm gray or like a bronze, but it's actually like a very soft gold. It's really cool. It would go really well with beige or any, like, Sandstorm, for example, might be good on this one. But pretty cool, pretty nice color. Pretty warm color on this. Like a muted green? No, this does not look green. This does look green on your camera, on the screen right now? No, this is not green. This is not green at all. GMK Boulder, yeah. I think the alphas, or was it the alphas? I think they're a little dark for my preference, but that could be a good set, actually. I think, like, GMK Bread or... what's that other set? Sloth? GMK Sloth, I think that was a good one. I think those sets might go pretty well with this, actually. Yo, Little Bonaparte, hello. Alright, let me, go back and just check. TKL train? Choo-choo, let's go. Doit, thank you so much for the Prime Gaming sub. I am going through my queue fairly quickly lately. But I do have orders coming in all the time, so... it kind of just goes back and forth like that. Something about those past QC stickers that look so cheap. I don't care. Thoughts on Tomo? I think the pricing is fair for rising costs of manufacturing, or rather of material, and well, also manufacturing it's pricey. So I think for that $525 or whatever for the Tomo is actually pretty fair. Not to mention, well, people need to feed themselves and their families and whatnot, so I think they have a right to charge whatever they want. And if that's not your budget, then it's, you know, you should be financially responsible and not get something that's too expensive for yourself. But yeah, UC definitely nicest dude in the hobby. Like, he doesn't give a shit, he's just nice. Reminds me of Pokemon Gold cartridges. Kind of reminds me more of the Zelda Gold cartridges a little bit, but yeah. But look at this color. Poor people don't deserve my keyboards. Oh, shit, look at this. Oh, the packaging? Oh, the packaging, I can show it. The only reason I didn't bring it out was because it had the address of the person, and I just was too lazy to cross it out. But basically it was box, factory foam, and two little thick, was it like those, I'll show you. Just so I don't have to show the the address here, but basically packaging was, you know, factory foam, essentially, packaging foam. And these things, these separators, just to make space for that to be like nice and tight, and some bubble wrap, and just like any accessories on top. So pretty standard. EPE foam, fiberboard, yeah. GMK Cafe? I actually don't like GMK Cafe that much. I think GMK Cafe is sorta too dark. Look at that. The stainless steel weight looks really good against the gold on this one. It's a nice contrast, actually. This is a really nice contrast to the gold. So pretty sick. Haven't seen the back. The back has this nice curve. Which is actually the part that I like the most about this board, is this back part here. The back part and the look of the weight is what I really like about this board. This double weight that has steel on the outside and brass on the inside. Pretty sick. Alright, so I don't think I need to open this up. It's pretty standard. Basically it's top mount, has a USB-C port with keyless, and the rest is just, you know, screws to attach everything together. So I don't think I need to show much of that. So I'm just gonna go straight to the stabs. see. What did I miss? One thing I realized going to get one answer, ask more about boards equals more delays. Yeah, maybe. Oh yeah, we have accessories here. Says to test our PCBs, which actually I'll do that first. And then we have our FR4 half plate. Pretty nice. And we have two PCBs, so I'm just gonna open up one, not two. So let's just open one of these guys. Ooh. Ooh. Look at this nice purple. Ooh. Look at that. Look at that. This is a nice purple PCB. I love this color. Purple PCB and yellow PCB, probably my two favorite PCB colors. Purple and yellow. Oh, and the color of the PCB of the hyphen prototype that I have, it was like a brownish color. That looked really cool too. I think those colors are probably my favorite colors for PCBs. Black, overrated. Red, overrated. Green, whatever. Blue, whatever. Yeah. I like these odd, more odd colors. They're more interesting. It's not like I see the PCB all the time anyway, so at least during the time I build it, it would be nice to see some interesting color. But yeah. Let's see, foam is called EP. It's recycled, which is cool. Oh, that's pretty neat. I didn't know that. Reminds me of the warm 910C gray. Yeah, actually it does remind me of the warm gray from 910C as well, Prox. Diego likes the rear of the keyboard. Confirmed Diego is an ass man. Fair enough. Fair assessment. To our staff tonight or nah? Maybe. Let's test this guy first though. Alright. So maybe if you hear background noise, that's just my AC because it's kind of hot. Let's see. Bottom row, wind keyless. The rest is fine. I'm just going to change a few things that I normally do. Actually, I think I should have a layout saved for myself. I guess not. Did it work? There we go. Yeah, that's fine. Alright. Is it 1.2? No, this is 1.6 millimeters. This is regular thickness. Sorry, I'm not getting to the questions quickly. Numpad looks a tad darker than the TKL to me. It is it's like a teeny bit darker than the TKL. So they're probably done in different times, not done in the same bath, or maybe this was in the bath for long. I don't know. But it's slightly darker than the. Than the TKO. Is that Sav on the KFE? No, it's EPVT Retro Cyrillic. Global Milky, hello. No, the anode is slightly different on the numpad. It's a tiny bit different, but I think in normal use you probably wouldn't notice too much. It's like whatever. Hiney's a punk, don't be intimidated. You wouldn't say it to his face. Hiney, you're a punk. And you know it. Staff too nice to use these days? What do you mean too nice? Yeah. Well, I'm the kind of person who gets stuff to use. So for me, leaving it unused seems like a huge waste. My salve key set, that's on a different board, so that's why I don't have it on this one right now. Yeah, but yeah, I'm more the type of person who like can't keep things like nicely wrapped up and unused. I feel like it's such a waste to do that. So I try to avoid doing that completely. I actually just unbox it right away. Like screw leaving things boxed up and like new. It's such a waste. That's just me though. Everyone has their own preference with that, I guess. Some people get scared of using stuff because they think that it's gonna, you know, devalue it or whatever. Or it's like too precious, historically significant or whatever it is. So, alright, I'll just leave the layout as is. And test matrix. What's the orientation of this? Okay, it's this way. Alright. Cool. Everything's working fine. You should just solder, no test. You shouldn't be telling me what to do. How about that? Process. All right, let's get going. I know I like using my salve, but I shouldn't have paid $600 for it. Yeah, it definitely was expensive, but I don't see it. I think now that I've been using it, I kind of don't feel too much regret having paid as much. I also paid something like that, pretty close to that, because that was what the guys from the story were selling for, right? Like $600 almost. Pretty crazy. Yo, Ninewalker, thank you so much for the 13 months, buddy. I hope you're well. Alright, first two steps. I don't understand Russian, I suppose, so can't read that. The Russia guys, yeah. Balloon and what's his name? Mind Game, I think. Forgot. TV2 to win. I ordered 80 red, 20 purple H10s instead of 2080. Oh, rip. Do you win any broadcasts from yesterday? I don't know if have the invoices gone out for those. I don't even know, but in any case, no. Right now, no. Not that I know. They look pretty cool though. All right, so we're gonna build the TKO first, and then we'll build the numpad next. Actually, we should just do all the stabs at once. So we're gonna need 3 more stabs, so let's do that. So 2, 4, 6, 8. Wait a sec, am I missing one? Oh, 10. Okay. And let's get all the wires together. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. He said hello from Russia. Oh, I see. Hello. Welcome, welcome. Which 910 model do you have again? I have the polycarb version. 910 RE polycarb. 2, 4, 6. 2, 4, 6, and three more wires. And the rest can go. Yeah, just put them together. It's fine. Alright, so let's see. Oh, interesting. The backspace doesn't take the plate. Huh, cool. Didn't realize that. I had forgotten from the last time I had built mine. Didn't realize the backspace didn't have the plate part. Alright, let's get our 205. TC910 easy to scratch. I never really did a scratch test, but I assume any polycarb is probably going to be a bit easy to scratch. It's not like super frosted, the polycarb 910, if I recall. So I could see it scratch. I could see it scratching, yeah. Would be sick to find a stash of NIBOG chair. I mean, yeah. What are your thoughts on OLEDs and rotary encoders? I personally think rotary encoders belong on like macro pads or not on the right side of the board. But personally, I think they look kind of ugly on boards, to be honest with you. I think they look better on like macro pads and such. So I would probably use it on the macro pad, but not on the board. What was the other question? Oh, OLEDs. I think OLEDs are cool, but in moderation. I don't think you should have any like big OLEDs, like kind of like just there. It's a bit intrusive. My voice sounds lower today. Did you just wake up from a nap? I don't know. Maybe I drank more water today. I don't know. Maybe. Oh, it's probably because I'm just not as agitated. When I get agitated, my voice pitch goes up. Probably. Gonna go eat dinner? Sounds good. Have a good dinner. The other was like, I see a Russian keyboard. That would be cool. It's not a Russian keyboard, it just has the Russian caps. Cyrillic caps. But yeah. Nothing special beyond that, though. And it's not a personal, no. It's not a personal keyboard, no. It says in the command. It's right there. Oh, if you mean the KFE, we built it last time, so no. So it's actually a client's. I'm just using it for now. What do people use OLEDs for? Can't think of any use. So if you look at the satisfaction 75, it has like indicators for like whether which function layer you're on, numlock, caps lock. It has like indicators for the time, or for like rant, like, you know, displays of like has like a keyboard display sort of thing that shows you like where you're typing, kind of like a heat map. I think on the Wampus that I've seen, it has basically you can animate things on the OLED, like people do like a bongo cat animation when you're typing, things like that. So there's a few, it's just like for fun OLED stuff. Yeah. So you can do a bunch of random. I mean, it's just a screen, so you can do whatever you want on it. So whatever you think you might want on a small little screen is what the OLED could be used for. You just have to program it. It's not like rocket science. All right, I think I've caught up with chat. Yeah. Oh, it's not worth unless I can watch porn on them. yeah, I guess the day we can get OLEDs with more than a few colors. I mean, I guess if it's like a phone screen, phone screen size OLED. Just a macro pad that's basically a gigantic OLED screen, and then maybe, I don't know, has a knob for your enjoyment or something. Something like that. Do you game? Are you a game dude? Right now I haven't been playing much beyond I've only been playing Genshin Impact lately, because I just do like daily stuff on it. Other than that, I'm waiting for Diablo 2 Resurrected and Diablo 4. Those are the two games I'm looking the most forward to. Which is quite a while from now anyway. Other than that, I just play like random games that people ask me to play occasionally. Like occasionally we'll pick up Apex or you know, Valorant or like Overwatch even sometimes. Rocket League every so often. Yeah. So yeah, don't play too many games right now. When can we get an OLED to play Lightning Streams? If that happened, I would look pretty shitty on that screen though. Do you break in your cherry switches? How long do you have to use them to make a difference? How do you know? Oh, do you know? To be honest with you, I don't break in my switches because I'm too lazy. I've broken in like cream switches just because I know that those break in decently quickly. But for cherry stuff, it's like I just check if it's smoothish enough after lubing. If it is, then I just kind of go with it. I've tried a few times to like quote unquote break in, and like, you know, I basically like pop them onto a plate, like onto like any plate, and then I'll like flip over the plate, put like piece of foam above and a piece of foam below, and just like step on it, right? Like kind of like you're basically pressing on all the switches all at once. It didn't really make a huge difference, or like at all. Like this is like the switch being stock, so the switch being like completely stock. But yeah, didn't really feel like it made a big difference, so I just gave up on it. I just don't do it. Only caught one part of it the other night when you were saying how you lube your linears. Do you just do the stem now mainly to preserve sound? Well, so yeah, sure, I'll explain again. I do stem only if I'm using a thick lube like 205. For 3204, which is slightly thinner, I occasionally consider doing the side rails of the bottom housing. If the switch is particularly scratchy and like might benefit from it. But the only reason I don't lube more than the stem like with 205 is just because 205 is so thick that if I do, it feels like it slows down the switch because it's just like so viscous, which is something that I don't enjoy. So that's the main reason why I don't do more than like the stem on with 205, because it just feels too thick. It feels like too much lube. How can anyone order a keyboard? You doing it for yourself? You mean like how do people get keyboards? Well, if you're new to the keyboard community, people do these things called group buys, where basically a design is put for like a group order. So basically it's like there's a vendor or like a designer who will organize these group buys, and you just participate in them. You pay money to the runner and they make a batch order, and then once those are produced and shipped to the vendor or designer, they get distributed to each of the individuals. But that's how like keyboard group buys work in our community. Either that, or there's some in-stock stuff every so often. Like for example, if you go on like KBD fans, or right now like I think Kaneki's has a few in-stock stuff like Devastating TKL and like Obliterate 75 and so on. They have some in-stock keyboards, and you can buy some of the in-stock keyboard kits right now, like right off the shelf. So, and then you can just buy parts like switches, stabilizers, keycaps, etc. to fill the rest. But if you're talking about like the build service, then it kind of depends. Like, you know, for example, like people who ask me to build stuff for them, they participate in the group buys themselves. And then they tell me like, oh, like, you know, whenever the group buy ships, I'll either have it shipped directly to you or have it or like, you know, just send it to you after I check it out, you know, things like that. So it varies. I lube stem only for JWK with 205. If I'm lubing cherry, I'll do stem and bottom housing. Yeah. So it kind of depends on what the switch is like. Which areas of the stem do you hit with 205? Pretty much all the surfaces hit. I do pretty much everything. Like front, back, sides, like fully as uniform as possible. And then I basically for the let me see if I can show you. I had some switches here. Oh, okay, here. This is not lube, so maybe we can just test run with this one. Yeah, it's not lube. So if I lube with 205, I'll just show you. Like, I'll just demo it right now. Basically, I'll lube like, you know, I'll just use my brush. Like, I have this flat brush with a little bit of 205. It's not a little bit too much. And then I'll just hit the side. And then I'll lube like this under part here. Like, you see this part that the bottom part that will hit the housing. And then basically just spread the rest of the lube everywhere else. On the front, so the front legs, just always make sure, for me, like I always make sure that the lube is spread, because I don't like it when it clumps on one of the edges, like on one of the edges here, like at the top or like at the bottom, because it makes it feel like a bit sluggish when it hits, when it like goes back up, or like when you start to press it down, like that's when it slows down the most, I feel. Not during the travel, but mostly during the very beginning or during the very end of the travel of the switch. And then just the back, and again just make sure that I just touch this, maybe like the pole just a little bit at the bottom, and that's it. And then, you know, you assume I already have a lubed spring, and then I'll just, you know, pop it on top, and maybe I already have a switch film on it, and then I'll just close the switch. I don't lube the top housing, I don't lube the bottom housing, unless I lube the bottom housing if this cherry switch, for example, is very scratchy. I'll lube the bottom housing too, because it kind of helps it glide a little better. But normally I don't bother. I think eventually I get used to them with when I'm typing. So, you know, I'll like close the switch. Yeah. So the reason I lube the bottom part of the slider like that is, and the top portion, like where it cusps, so like basically this part here, let me show you, is because I actually, what I like about lube switches, what I notice that I enjoy more about lube switches is not the smoothness exactly, it's actually that when you bottom out, the sound is slightly more muted. So basically I always make sure like this top part here and this bottom part here are always lubed, and lubed as evenly as possible, because the slightest bit of lube kind of clumping there makes it feel sticky. Yeah. Yeah, so that's kind of like how I go about switches in general. And doing stem only, of course, saves a bit of time. If you're using something like 205, And I think the difference is not like crazy. I actually just really felt like as I was doing the bottom housings for 205 with 205, I just felt like the switch was too sluggish. Oh wait, I was not gonna use this. I'm just gonna wipe this down. Yo, Drewas, what's up, buddy? Alright. It stopped becoming more common for high-end keyboards. Yeah. I definitely enjoying seeing in-stock keyboards, to be honest, because it's such a nice experience to have something shipped right away after you pay for it. It's such a nice experience. Personally, you know, for me, just because I don't mind the wait as much as some other people do, I don't mind paying less and waiting than, you know, paying more, like paying a slight premium and getting it now, you know. It's one of those things that some people have less tolerance for or like more tolerance for. Just depends on the person. Yeah. I'm sorry, Sean. Diego, my man, how do you deal with a breakup? Asking for a friend? Oh, buddy. I'm sorry. If you've already processed some of those emotions yourself, I think first I tend to take some time to process those emotions myself, just by myself. If it's too much to bear, or if you've already processed them to some extent, I talk to friends about it. I just tell them about it. I don't make it a big deal. I just tell them about it. Tell them what happened. Tell them what I think went wrong. Tell them what I think could be different. Just to kind of see how they, like, you know, like I like having people listen to that and then sort of just give me their take on it, rather than feeding my own input, like in addition to just like the facts, which is like, you know, what I think happened. But yeah, I think kind of rehashing some of the story, some of the things that happened in a relationship or like in things that happen to me in daily life, it gives me a lot more clarity and it helps me resolve a lot of those feelings. But it's tough. It's never gonna be easy. Yeah, you just have to. It takes time, though. Yo, Nachos, thanks for the tier 1, buddy. Thank you so much. And Sean, thanks for the 3 months. Oh, Sean, 3 months. You can get a sticker if you want. You want a sticker? You should fill the form. Exclamation stickers. If you've been 3 months or longer for a sub, you can get a free sticker. The rules are written in the form, so just make sure you read all that. You can get a free sticker. I actually have like a whole batch of them to send out. I was going to do it today, but I didn't manage to get to the post office, so I'm gonna do it probably tomorrow. Does anyone know how the lilac TK1 compares to purple KFE? They look similar in color. I haven't seen the KFE in person, but it does kind of look similar in photos, at least. Which is like a slightly on the, like kind of like slightly more tinted lilac, but it's not like a super light color actually. Even the hiney TK1 is also not like a super light purple. that's just based on photos though. It's hard to say. You would have to like really just put them next to each other to really know how they differ. But yeah, Sean, sorry for what happened, but you know, if you need to vent or anything like that, you know, you can, you know where to find me. So can we take a sip together? Sounds good. Cheers. Oh, yo, GZ, thank you so much for the sub. Appreciate it, man. Ooh. Oh, Manoli, my man. How you doing, buddy? Thank you so much for the raid. Hello, raiders. How y'all doing? Hope you are doing well. Hope your day was good. Some vague details for you. Decided to break up because she needed work on herself. Family and school was too much and she didn't want to neglect me. Rationally, I understand, but emotionally, it is not the same. Hmm. I understand it. I've had someone say that to me too, so I kind of understand what that means. I think it's fair though. It's a two-way street after all, Sean. So I think respecting the two-way is important, because it's like no matter how much you offer to help, the other party needs to accept the help, right? And that, no matter how much you insist, in the end, it's a choice that they have to make. So, yeah. I do think, like Nacho said, it is, you could see it in a positive light if you think of it as something that prevented something worse. That's another way to see it, which I think is true. Better to have that particular phase of things pass by sooner than later. That way it doesn't get even more convoluted than it already is. But yeah, that's just like a general view of how that could be. We're still friends, but I know what to do. So I'll be honest with you, Sean. I'm friends with like a lot of the people that I've been partners with before. Like I still talk to them. We talk like adults do, like, you know, we just talk about stuff, we're friendly and all that, and it's like we still recognize that we, you know, at some point we, like, you know, had romantic feelings or whatever, but it's, you know, we all each have our own lives, and like what you appreciate of that person is more than just those romantic feelings. So I think it's if you learn to accept that, like if you learn to like take what you have, like what's valuable about yourself and of this other person, it makes for a very nice friendship, because you kind of don't have to go through all the small talk, and you don't have to go through all the things that you need to know to understand someone really well, right? And yeah, there's gonna be barriers set up again because you can't cross a certain line, but it's not a bad thing. Do you know who Shubes is? I've heard of them, yeah. They're on like YouTube, I think, right? I know that they do like sort of meme-y sort of videos and like, you know, like reviews of stuff and whatnot. But I don't know them too well, to be honest. And also, it's not like my it's not my preferred sort of like scope for keyword content anyway. So for me, it's like it's just like I'm not a target audience for it. Yeah. If you love someone, then let them do what they want. If they come back, then it was meant to be. Hmm. I think you did well, Sean. I think you did the right thing. You left it, you know, you extended yourself to where you can, and you've left the decision, you know, left to them to make. And if they, that's what the decision is, then, and you respect it, I think that's the best outcome. So I think you did what you could do. Yo, P-Buzzle, good evening. How are you? How are you? Everything in life is transient, even hiney keyboards, indeed. You know, I still have... Where is... Ah, yes, here it is. Here it is, right here. Boom. Everything in life, like keyboards. Nothing serious, board is just a board. By Mr. Kevin Lim of Linworks. It's a life motto. Keyboards are just keyboards. You enjoy them. You pass them forward to other people, and you know, let them enjoy it. They're fun. They're cool. But it's still just a keyword. Which Lin? Lin from Linworks is the designer of the Dolphin, the Whale, Montage, EM7, Dollinger, etc. That Lin. Kevin is one of the people who work with Lin over at Linworks. So Linworks mainly consists of Lin is the designer, Linux 3 or Lin, and then Kevin and Stepstone are like admins who help behind the scenes with logistics. Oops. QC, packing, blah blah blah, all that kind of stuff. Administrator stuff. So you like if you're asking about design stuff to Kevin, he won't have an answer because he needs to like check with Lin, for example. Lin is the one who does all the design related stuff. From like start to finish. That's just something you're telling your viewers so you have a better chance at winning board raffles? Okay, buddy. Don't you work with them? I see there all the time. Yeah. I'm a moderator for the Discord. Yeah, I help them with like liaison stuff between the Western community and for themselves because they're in Korea, and there's a language barrier and whatnot. So I help them with logistics on that end, and connect them to like people and whatnot. Unfortunately, I came in to the crew a little too late. By the time I joined the crew, the Rose Cables collab was confirmed, which was a bummer. Too soon? Oh, it's never too soon, it's never too late. I mean, hard to believe, but this person's still around in the community, right? So, under different names all the time, so it's pretty... Such a sad existence. Lying your way through things is just not cool. Not cool at all. I don't know about you, Diego, but not taking grad course right now has me big chilling. Oh, dude, I feel you. Not having all of those deadlines, definitely such a relief, dude. Totally get it, Reborn.
Appreciate you always, brother, for the time you've given me.
I appreciate you too, Sean. Thank you so much. New Singer or the new TGR mono keyboard? That pretty much just depends on you. What layout do you like more? Why don't you pick based on the layout and the look that you like? You know, that's not a question for anybody else, to be honest. People are always like, but what about the feel and the sound? It's like, well, we don't know. It's like, we just don't know what that's like right now. It's like, have your sample size for the people who might have tried that keyboard is like 1 or 2. And that's just not a good way to assess things. Just go for it based on the look and the design that you like. I pretty much pick my boards based on how they look most of the time. And as long as they're not like, as long as they don't look like they have like design flaws, meaning like, you know, like things that could definitely fail. Yeah. I get up at 5 p.m. and just watch Twitch and play video games. Life feels good. Oh, dude, that's great. What's the summer like as a grad student? Summer as a grad student, specifically for someone in a research school, like in a research-based school or like a research-based program, your job in the summer normally is to do research. So you work in the lab full-time. So you set your own schedule, or maybe you have a schedule if you're in, like in a wet lab and you have experiments to run. But you're a full-time lab person, so you're a full-time research. Doing research and trying to progress in the projects that you're engaged in, and you know, having meetings with your supervisor slash like PI or principal investigator, right? Like the head of the lab, to basically, you know, guide your work. And yeah, so you're basically a full-time research assistant. That's the job of a... So summer is actually a time of, as far as research is concerned, it's kind of high pressure, because you're supposed to get a lot more done during the summer than during the regular term, because you have no school things to do. So they expect you to do more in the summer. They expect you to do a lot more in the summer than any time else. Yeah.
$3 is 2 weeks, ZZZZ.
Thanks, Sean, for the $5. You don't have to, you know. That's why I got a Bear 65. Shit was cute. Yeah, there you go. That's exactly why, how you just choose a board. Like, you think it's cute, you think it looks good. Yeah, just go for it. Can I get a My Brother? Oh, my brother. Max stream, gotta show some support. Sounds good, buddy. Take care. I'll talk to you soon. I'm full-time research right now, sit my ass on the computer all day and read papers. That sounds like research for sure. Well, reading papers is one thing, and then the next step is to know what you like, you know, what you think you should be doing to make something or do something in the lab, right? after reading those papers. It's like, you should guide your own thought process after that. That's a hard part of doing research. It's like knowing what to do. It's like figuring out what's the next thing to do. Because it's all up to you, right? Like, you need to, like, figure out, like, what you think is what's needed in your current, like, lab. In the current state of, like, your projects. It's the hard part. But, yeah. I feel you. I know exactly what it is like to be a full-time research person, because I've done a lot of that. A lot of that. Don't you get bored of doing research? Yeah, of course it gets boring. It's an ebb and flow. It has its good parts and its rewarding parts, and it's boring and tedious and discouraging and completely not motivating moments. It has both parts. Just like work can be, you know, any work can be like that. So yeah. Of course it has its highs and lows.
Also, $8 is a weak amount we round up here.
Sean, thanks for the total of $10. Thank you so much, buddy. It's not weak though. You don't have to. You know that everything counts. Even just you being here counts. You don't have to. You don't have to donate. You don't have to sub. I appreciate it though. This man's on the big side, he's out here giving Diego monies. Is this what retail therapy is like? Multiples of 5? I see. Is 5 your favorite number? People quantify goodness of research in a lot of ways. What journal gets published in, how many other papers end up citing it. Oh yeah, I personally think the whole impact factor and all that bullcrap is bullshit. It's unfortunate, but it's a reality with science. Not to mention science is not cross-valued that well either. Like, a lot of experiments out there are not replicable and whatnot. It's good science, but it's not replicable science a lot of the time too. So it's kind of tough. It's really tough. Some fields also just get the advantage because they're like the hot thing at the time. It's timing. There's a lot of timing, luck. There's power play and politics involved too, of course. It's the reality of academia. But at the same time, it's you kind of go in thinking like what you have to contribute to that, rather than thinking of how awful it is and how cynical you can be, right? I think that's just kind of how you have to kind of deal with it. It's like you need to just be your best self and put your best foot forward and do your thing, and then, you know, if you're out, then you're out. Like, you just get out of it as soon as you're like, you know, you reap your benefits, and then you get out of it. I think that's kind of how it should, it can be. Yeah, sometimes some things are just not worth spending time stressing about. And some of that includes like how that kind of stuff is perceived, like your worth and your value in that like particular field stuff. Yeah, at least for me, that's how I feel. It's like, can you share a big POC moment when you're doing research? Okay, so I mean, a big POC moment when doing research is if you make something that is clearly consequential, like, or it's clearly causal towards the making of like a new product, or like something that can get patented, or something that's like key for like a new, like, you know, technological advancement slash, like, you know, if you're in drug delivery, maybe like that, or pharmaceuticals, like that kind of, you know. Maybe you like worked on like a certain protein or a certain gene. That would be a big POC moment. Like, a big POC moment is when you realize the effects of your work being actually meaningful towards the advancement of something tangible, something that's real, or something that's going to like trailblaze a certain field. That's a big pop moment. When you realize how much impact your work has and it's actually meaningful in real life, that's when you're like, whoa, holy shit, I actually put something down here, and it's like forever immortalized in a journal, right? Like forever immortalized because people will cite it, right? People will be like, oh, this person did this work that was pivotal in the advancement or the, you know, starting of this. That's a big pop moment. 14 is my favorite number. Oh, I see. No one runs replication studies? Yeah, that's real. Not to think that years of work end up in what basically amounts to a single fact. Yeah, that's the reality though. That's just the remember, I always think to myself that pursuing academia is a very noble path, but it definitely does not have the rewards you get from it. It's very perspective based. Like, you have to think of it in a very optimistic fashion, where you realize how much you get out of it because you know how much you put into it. Like, you know, whether it's like the network you build or like the enjoyment of doing the work that you're doing, you kind of have to find that. I feel like if you don't do that and you try to just quantify it based on what that like real world impact is, and it doesn't amount to much, like when you think about it, you're gonna be miserable, I think, because the reality is academia has its limitation in how they recognize certain achievements, and it's just part of the system. Like, it's a systemic issue. Is it easier to do research while doing the devil's lettuce? Some people say yes, some people say no, so I don't know. My buddy works on nuclear safeguards, developing frameworks on how to handle nuclear incidents that will never get references for first responders. His field's impact is BS. Oh, I see what you mean. Very situational stuff, huh? Yeah, that stuff is kind of rough. Like, you can feel very miserable thinking about how that like is limited to its own little niche like arena, and it can be very like, very demoralizing. I certainly feel that way. I felt that way at one point when I was doing research, because you know, and like when I was in physics, and I used to do like molecular physics and like high energy physics and stuff, and I moved away from it because I kind of felt that way. Eventually I moved towards like engineering because of that. And even in engineering, it's kind of the same. Like, there's like a certain competitive nature to it that also lends to like feeling pretty bad about yourself. Like, there's a lot of imposter syndrome, and yeah. So in a way, I haven't really felt like I'm worse off than like my peers who work full time, like at a R&D job, which, you know, or like a contractor, right? Doing research on their own projects, and like, you know, they can see things tangible because there's these big teams working together to make things happen. Like, you know, if you, let's say you work for like the defense industry, or you work for like I don't know, like Google, like, you know, like science, but like behind it is like backed by Google or like some like big company, right? Or like, let's say like Big Pharma, for example. Like, Big Pharma is a good way to see it. Like, you could see that these things kind of like progress towards these like real products. And so it might make you like feel great about it, but that's just the like illusion of like of scale. Like that like your particular like affiliation has this like pull, and so therefore like your achievements are shared like that. So it's that definition of feeling happy just varies with a lot of perspective. Some people just feel miserable feeling like they didn't do anything. Kind of like Lightning Keyboards is immortalized and cited in keyboards. That would be interesting. If I become immortalized in keyboards, I will consider that an achievement. I'll put it as a fun fact somewhere, and I'll tell my kids about it. And I'll be like, I used to be a, you know, mechanical keyboards. There were these devices used to type in letters and numbers to your computer, and I used to build these things. Yeah, I'll totally tell my children about it or something like that, or my friends. Where's all your biggest fans? I don't know. I don't define that. I know some people have been following for a long time, like Ninewalker and like Dashkov have been following me for a long time. There's a recent like client of mine who's like a repeat client of mine who we talk very often. We talk about artisans, we talk about keycaps, all that kind of stuff. There's a few people here who we talk about like anime. Some makers that I just interact with on a very regular basis, and we just like talk shit to each other, and you know, we talk about like nothing related to keyboard sometimes. Yeah, it's just I'm not sure if they're like fans or biggest fans. I don't know how to define that. It's kind of limited. It's like I don't know how to define that. It's hard to say. How do you even know? Anime? Yeah, Jujutsu Kaisen. My brother. My friendo. Yeah, exactly. Alright, so let's try to get these screwed in. Wait, I enjoy the process enough that the end result consequences are really just an added bonus. Yeah. Oh, good night, one drunk man. Sorry I missed that. Do you do molecular dynamics? Yeah, I used to do molecular collision simulation stuff. 8-Pebble. So like Monte Carlo simulations, like atomic collision simulations and stuff. I used to do that. And then I worked a summer in an accelerator lab down in Virginia. Jefferson Lab, if you know it. I worked there for a bit, for like a summer. That was fun, like working with like high energy electron guns and stuff. You know, like collisions associated with them. One day the high board we're using today will become vintage. Yeah, I'm sure that one day my most treasured board might be like my JMV2 or whatever, you know, like will be worthless, you know. No one will care jack shit about it, and that's fine. I bought them to use to keep, you know. Whatever. Currently a Navy medic. When I help a patient they leave happy, I always feel really good. It helps me get through class for nursing. Ooh, that's amazing. That must be super rewarding for sure. Let's see. In 20 years, some guy is going to be looking for some dry vintage NK creams broken into no end. Dude, that's hilarious. I'm your biggest fan, Senpai. Notice me. You know, I appreciate like a lot of y'all support. Like honestly, like for me, just interacting with people, like you know, shooting shit about stuff is fun. That's why I actually would like to encourage y'all to join the Discord if y'all are looking for yet another place among your 100 server lists on Discord. I have a Discord you can join, and it's actually a very quiet place, so I actually enjoy it a lot. Because the discussions are pretty focused or like low volume, so it's much easier to focus on them. Yeah. Kids these days. Let's see. I wish I did physics, I'm kind of booty at it. Well, that's why I didn't do grad school in physics. I decided to move away from it and do engineering. Because I knew that I was physics grad school, specifically like a PhD in physics, is legit for people who are like fucking geniuses. Like straight up, they know exactly what they're gonna do. So these people are amazing. Like, amazing drive. Amazing, like... Like, they're amazing thinkers, just in general. Like, they're so, like... systematic, and... They really, like, process a lot of things really well. Really, in a, such an organized fashion. Anyway, let's see. Very close to what I do. I do Monte Carlo simulations for high-energy photogenic transfer. Oh, I see. Yeah, well, my research was basic research, though. It was to understand, basically, the collisions of, like, the simplest atom molecule systems, like the hydrogen, plus deuterium, or, you know, like, barely up to, like, carbon level stuff. Like, we would, like, deal with noble gases and, like, things that have no reaction, like, no chemical reaction. Like, we were basically studying the basis of the chemical reaction, is what we were studying back then, what I was doing on research. And what kind of sucked was that I never really got published on that. The grad student who was supposedly going to help me and help other people, like, write the paper and, like, kind of integrate a lot of their work, graduated and never ended up doing it. So, plop, never really got official quote-unquote credit on that. So, yeah, but it was fun. While I did the research, I actually learned a lot, and it was actually pretty fun. Kind of bombard your anime channel. Oh, that's fine though. That's what it's meant to be. I actually like serious discussion about, like, shows and, like, whatever, you know. I like it when people get passionate over their little, like, niche stuff. That's the fun part of having a community. Alright, let's test out these switches and stabs. Half plate first, and then we'll do the rest later. Okay. PG physics is no freaking joke. Oh yeah. Oh, the physics GRE, dude. There was one point I was doing, like, the physics GRE stuff. Yeah. I audited. I did audit a few PhD classes for physics, like, and it was just. There was this one class, I think. Was it classical mechanics, or was it... No, I think it was mathematical physics. We took the same quiz 3 times because the average on the quiz was 15%. So the professor asked us to take the quiz again 2 weeks later, and then again 2 weeks later, because everybody kept failing it. I mean, I learned a lot. But it just showed to how fucking difficult it was. Like, it was like Green's function related shit, right? And it was just like taking your multivariable calculus to, like, a whole new dimension in the context of physics. It's just like, yeah. Don't know what to do. You just stare at the piece of paper and you're like, I think I'm just gonna leave. I think I'm just gonna need to leave. Alright, let's get our keycaps to test our stabs. Where's our keycap bag? Oh, here it is. let's see. When you tell your mom you failed, they just say, well, study harder. Facts. Well, I actually never told, like, my parents, like, oh, I failed this test, or, like, you know, or, like, you know, over, like, smaller things. Because I know that they're just gonna say something like that, or that they you know, like, it's kind of like, oh, like, you know, just, don't forget to eat well, or that kind of stuff, you know? It's like we can't do much about it, so, you know, we're rooting for you, but good luck. Just double check this screw here. Maybe it's a little tight. A little less tight. Class mathematics and physical chemistry for chem grads and got absolutely owned. Yeah, grad courses, especially like basic science math, like courses that are based on math, like math based courses for basic sciences, so chemistry, bio, physics, whatever it is, shit gets real hard. Why your wire so straight? What do you mean, why? What can I do about it? Look like they're gonna like chip off. Got a dip. Hope the rest of the stream goes well. Thank you so much, Nuclear Nachos. Draw a circle, eat a hot dog, yell Larry twice, and it'll solve itself. Sounds about right, though. Pretty good. Let's take off this QC sticker since I think someone was bitching about it. I was like, well, if it looks cheap, let's just take it out. We'll have a full purple PCB. Also, plus, we know it works. Alrighty. Alright, good. I was bitching, Miami. It's okay. I bitch about other things all the time, too, so. Alright, let's finish up this half plate. Okay, let's just do all the switches. But let's finish up the half plate placement first. And we'll do the rest. Where can you get this keyboard? Was it a group buy from a while ago? Yes, it's a keyboard that got delivered from a group buy, yeah. When did the Hiney KKL one run? It was a while back, but yeah. It indeed is a group buy delivered KKL. No idea if Hiney will do another round. I think he said he was working on some new stuff, right? So why don't you? I think his Discord has updates on like his projects, so probably the best place to see what the status on things are or like what he's working on. If not, if he's in chat, maybe he can tell you, but I'm not sure if he is right now. So. Oh yeah, 10 Peaches, if you're around, I just recently finished The Devil's a Part-Timer. That was fun. It's a fun show. I'm not sure what to watch next right now. I heard there's gonna be a second season with modernized animation. He's supposed to work on EBS next? Oh yeah, okay. EBS, I'm not sure how to pronounce, but I'll say EBS because it's easier, I think. Ibis? Ibis? Whatever. Yeah, whatever. I don't care. Amazing how when I got started in the hobby, getting a Toofy was like insanely expensive, and I see a 500 can't think of myself. Yeah, that's pretty cheap. Yeah, that's what happens to you. Your spending tolerance changes completely for sure. And then you, when you miss out on something, and then you're like, oh, aftermarket, not bad. This is a good deal. It only costs like 1.8 times what it originally cost. Not a bad deal. And you're like, But yeah, that shit's real. Second season hype though. That's fun. It was a fun show. I thought it was pretty cute. Cute setup. Everything's all the way in before I go with the half plate part. And I'm just gonna put all the half plate switches in. Okay. Looks pretty good to me. Oopsie. Maybe I should solder this, huh? Actually, no, it's fine. It's just this part here. Okay. Alright, let's do the half plate portion. Plate portion should be easy though. It's all the way in, no plate to clip on. Wait, I just got back and you're done with staves? Hasn't even been 2 hours. I know. God. I still have 3 more staves to do for the numpad though. I just decided to do the TKL stuff first. But I do still need to do my numpad portion. Tolerance is a wild thing. Yeah, I do agree. Hydrate. Okay, let's hydrate. Ahem. Have you seen Watakoi Love is Hard for Otaku? No, I haven't. I don't think so. Because the recent shows I watched were Anohana and Devil's a Part-Timer. Those were my two most recent ones. Actually, do I have an any list command here? I actually don't remember. Maybe not. Okay, I guess I don't have a command. I think maybe on my Discord I have a command, but basically I have a link. My any list is linked somewhere in the Discord, and basically you can follow the progress of what I've watched recently. But yeah, no. Let's see. Ran out of space. Do you usually break in retool blocks or hyperglides? Do you think they'll break in over time if I lube them? Just lube them. Forget about it. I personally think if they're smooth-ish enough stock, I just kind of move on with it. I don't have the patience to break things in and stuff anymore. I just kind of just go with it. Because I figure, like, as I'm trying different boards and stuff, my, like, sensitivity to those things kind of has been dropping. And it's actually kind of nice because ignorance is bliss, you know? So, yeah. I'm trying to be, you know, I think some scratchiness on cherry is kind of expected at this point, so I kind of just give up on it. Like, if it's really bad, like, I can hear the scratch and, like, it just, like, sounds terrible and feels terrible, then, yeah, I'll like, go for other switches. But if it's, like, slightly, like, if it's smooth enough, and if it smoothens a little bit further with the lube, then that's, like, more than enough for me. I just stop mining too much on whether it's, like, the smoothest batch I have ever tried. Yeah. Beep boop, I'm a bot, thank you. Do you finish AOT? I haven't finished AOT, actually. I didn't finish AOT. Because isn't Attack on Titan split up? The last part, the last season? Isn't it split up? I haven't finished it, though. I basically was waiting for it to air so I could just binge it all at once. So that's why I didn't watch it. But I will most certainly watch it. That's a fact. Let's get the numpad section done, actually, because I just wanted to turn on my soldering iron once and just do all the soldering all at once. So this part is done. Let's just finish up this numpad segment really quick. I think I can just do it really fast, so it's not a problem. That way we can just have everything all at once, and I can get the lube out of the way, get this all out of the way, solder all quickly at once, and then we can assemble both of them together and listen to them together instead of y'all having to wait and then whatnot. So yeah, not a true weeb. What is it, just me that likes the scratch sound of cherry switches? Some people do. Coin Roamers and others are all aboard your 3204 and linear stream. Maybe I should try it out in my new hyperglides. I personally love 3204 and my linears in general, because it just doesn't feel as thick and sluggish as 205. I mean, 205 is actually pretty good. Again, that's why I only apply it on stems, because by doing so I can basically do as close to as what I like for 3204 without having to, like, you know, do extra work. Final season is in two parts, just finished a few weeks back. Oh, okay. Oh, first part just finished. See? I'm gonna wait until the second part finishes up, One Way Theory, for Attack on Titan. Yeah. I don't wanna wait for the second part. I don't wanna wait on cliffhangers, I don't wanna follow the season. It's too annoying. Can't with a show like Attack on Titan, especially, because it has a ton of cliffhangers and, like, it's an interesting story, so it's like, yeah, I just don't want to do that. I'll watch all of these things that I haven't watched in the meantime. Stabs again. Got him. Good evening, Vile Deacon. Hello, hello. intermittent fasting. What? Fasting? What blasphemy is this? Fasting? No. Miss me with that stuff. Embrace the food. I get it that people do it, but I just don't. I can't understand it myself. Or I just can't do it myself. I fast by default, but when I forget to eat dinner or something like that. I just sometimes legitimately just forget to eat. And I'm like, huh. Why do I feel hungry right now? Huh. Oh, I forgot I skipped lunch or skipped dinner. Yeah, happens. Happens quite often, actually. I'm like, huh. Food wasn't in front of me, so I skipped the meal. Water down 205 with 105. The problem with mixing 205 with 105, though, is the fact that they can eventually separate. Your mixing agrees with the oil, and so it might eventually separate. This is why G0 was done. Like, the whole reason behind using 3204 tribosis, right? 3203, 3204, and then 25 grade 0. The whole idea of grade 0 is that it's so evenly mixed in that the separation is very minimal, and that you don't have to rely on mixed lubes to lube your switches, because mixed lubes eventually do separate and they pool at the bottom of your switch. That's the whole point of using 3204 and 205 only, instead of mixing them. So in a way, it's like you're rolling back in time by mixing. Yo, have a good night, Juan. Thanks for stopping by, dude. I've been trying to watch Jujutsu Kaisen. I can draw so many parallels from shonen genre, so I'm kind of not that into it. Yeah. Yeah, it's a very shonen show. That's just the reality of Jujutsu Kaisen. It's like peak shonen. Peak shonen for this year, I think. It's like, if I have to give it to one particular show this past year, it's that one. Find a vase separate, I'll just shake the board and mix them again. Shake the board. Oh, that's ridiculous. Odd Taxi's anime of the year, I'm sorry. I heard it's good. I haven't watched it though. I don't watch things that are airing. I just the only thing I watched while it was airing was ReZero, and that's because ReZero is one of the best anime of all time. Period. Sorry. Prove it? How do I prove it? I watch. You should watch it. You should just watch it. Just read it, watch it, whatever. Get into it. I love Emilia, and I bought GMK Frostwitch. Yes. That's my proof, I guess. Koi keeps telling me to watch it. You should. It's a fun show. I think it's fun to watch, especially now that the second season is fully out and you can just binge everything all together. You should just watch the director's cut for the first season and then watch the second season. It's a good show. I think it definitely gets... some people tend to overanalyze things and they're like, oh my god, but this character trope is bad. It's so bad. But like... It has a very cool setup for the world and whatnot, so I actually like it a lot. The characters have a lot of development, there's a lot of focus on secondary characters too. Which is something that I do enjoy a lot, character development. So... That's CRP on the TKL, it's not. It's, CRP doesn't have server like that, so it's actually, EPVT. CRP R4 is bringing Cyrillic, Red Cyrillic for the first time on CRP. So, yeah. It's definitely not a fun show, but it's incredible. I think it's a fun show. I legitimately have a lot of fun watching ReZero, but that's just me. Recently watched Castlevania. Ooh, Castlevania. Well, I love Castlevania, the games, but the whole premise of Castlevania is a very fun. It's also a very fun setup. So, I could definitely vouch for it. I have not watched like the animated series, but I could imagine it's fun because I know the premise of Castlevania from the games. So, I would bet that it's a fun show to watch. ReZero gives me full body sadness, please. There's some wholesome moments too, though. Like Best Boy Otto. Really interested in watching the Castlevania anime? Yeah. Same. Do you get CRP R4? Yeah, I will. And Patty, what? Really what? Really what? What was it really about? Gonna use Frost Switch on the U87V? Yeah, that'll be nice. That Red Cyrillic on CRP? Yeah. Red Cyrillic on CRP, R4 is the first time they're bringing Red Cyrillic for CRP, yeah. Yeah, really. Just look it up. It's not too hard. CRP round 1 had Tulip, Greek Tulip, Peacock, and what else? Greek Tulip, Peacock, and something else. And then they're the bonus sets, which were Hebrew, the two Hebrews, Moscow Knights or Cyrillic Knights, and JP, like the Sakura Pink. And then there was, oh, and Arabic. Forgot about Arabic. Yeah, Arabic was in round 1 too. And then round 2 had, what? Yeah, round 2 had Desco. Desco, Tulip, Peacock, APL, and I don't remember. And then round 3 had Peacock, APL, Tulip, and I don't remember. Oh, Desco Black, 2551 HAD, Japanese Black Pink, I don't remember what else. Oh, Xerox. And then R4 has all of these things. Has Xerox, Japanese Black Pink, 2551 HAD, Desco Mods, Desco Black, Orange and Red Cyrillic, Tulip and Greek Tulip, Green Hebrew and Blue Hebrew, APL, Arabic, Peacock, regular ANSI. Well, yeah. Pretty much has everything from the previous runs, most things from the previous runs. And some and then Cyrillic and Hebrew is running again, so pretty cool. TBH. And then I guess white Xerox is what's new, I guess. It's new. Yeah. Better compatibility this time too, so totally worth it in my opinion. For CRP round 4. So yeah, I'm definitely going in on CRP round 4, no doubt. actually getting a pretty fat order of Serbian Round 4. Actually, I've been saving to pay for that. So yeah, if you donate anything today, it's probably going to the CRP fund. Actually, I do have a question for y'all. If, let's say you were to think about where would you want to see the stream to go as far as like for donos or subscriptions and stuff, you know, of course that's like, you know, there's part of it that's money that comes to me and whatnot, right? What would you want to see me upgrade? Like, I can't really upgrade my PC because that's too expensive, but like what would you want to see me invest for the stream, for the purpose of the stream, or for the purpose of, you know, quality of the stream, whatever. Yeah. Wish CRP Moscow Knights came back. There's people selling that set, I think. I'm kind of like whatever about that set, to be honest with you. Where's the other screws? Oh, here. More cat lighting. Oh, more lighting would actually not be a bad idea. What are those super like RGB lights? Those RGB lights could be fun. Like the ones that like Alex has or like some other people have, like those RGB lights that you can like hang up and stuff. I forget what they're called. Is there anything you don't like with your setup? No, I'm a very frugal kind of person, so I tend to settle for what I have a lot of the time. So I don't really have complaints. The only complaint I have is my internet being shit sometimes. My room getting hot sometimes, but that's kind of resolvable with the AC. And obviously my computer is starting to get old as time goes by. So I think the next real upgrade, it would be a PC upgrade, to be honest with you guys, but it's kind of far away. And I guess another big upgrade I could do is front cam, to use an actual camera instead of a webcam, because right now it's a webcam for my front cam. If you want to see my face in 4K, I mean in 1080p, if you want to see my pores and stuff, and like my acne, then maybe I could upgrade my camera to an actual front-facing camera, like a full digital camera. But I'm not too keen on it because I think it's an extra expense that I actually wouldn't end up using the camera a lot other than for stream. Like that would probably be the only use I really have. I'm not really planning on doing videos and stuff because it's just content that I'm not used to doing. I've never really made or recorded videos for, like, you know, like YouTube or whatever, like that style. I just don't know how to do videos. So yeah, I don't know. I would have to think about that one. Nanoleaf, yeah, Nanoleaf. Nanoleaf are those things. Yeah. Invoices do be out now for Bro? Oh, I see. Didn't know that. Okay, let me go down and read. Mr. Mara, how are you doing? Just saw you. Deke only takes like 2 hours to do stabs. It's only to steal? It's not too bad. I still charge the same though. I don't charge. Hot tub? No, that's not gonna happen. I'm in New York especially. It's just too small. So my room's a mess. I need to organize my room better. Alrighty, so let's see. Yeah, Nanoleaf. I don't really know. Stream is close to perfect. Oh, that's good to know. I mean, it's good to hear that people like the layout of stream and whatnot. So that's good. Oh, I need to test this with the plate. So I need to open this guy up actually. This uses Torx. Oh, hiney, using Torx. Some accent lights, macro for some scenes. Oh yeah, I do need to set some transitions. Transitions would be kind of cool. I need to figure out how to do that. Wait, where's my? Oh, Here it is.
A very frugal hobby for keyboards.
Lightning coasters? Could be fun doing some accessories. Another friend for JD? There is another friend. Nono is gonna be another friend for JD. 6 camera, 10 consoles, dock cam, cat cam. JD cam. JD cam would be hilarious. Something that you want to do on stream but haven't? TBH, I'm pretty happy with stream. I have to be honest with you. I'm using Durock stabs, Big Rick. OG Big Rick. Using Durock stabs. Natalie, part of the streamer starter pack, yeah. Like I don't have streamer starter pack stuff, which is aperture lights, a stream deck, and Natalie. Those are the three things that I think are like classic streamer starter pack. But I don't have. Bonbons. Let's just put them on. Lightning merch would be interesting, but I actually would want to make it something like fun or something nice and usable, something practical would be pretty good for it. I'm not sure what that would be though. Like a t-shirt? I think a t-shirt or a sweatshirt would be kind of neat. Or a desk pad maybe? But I need ideas. I actually need someone who is a designer to help me out on this stuff, because I'm not a creative guy, you guys. Like, I'm not a very creative person. I'm too rational. Kind of see things on a very pragmatic scale, and so I kind of don't really think about extra decorations and making things pretty. I actually suck at that stuff. My room's a mess for that reason. It's like, things kind of look a little bit out of place. Transitions? Yeah, I think I should work on transitions though. That's something I need to work on. Okay, let's take out this QC sticker. But yeah, I'll learn about transitions from somebody. Maybe I'll ask, maybe Alex could help me out with that? I think he kind of has that too. Transitions. Miago Fight hoodie, yo. Yo, Miago Fight hoodie sounds kind of cool. What if Miago Fight, like right here, like left side Miago Fight, like just small, and it just can be a hoodie, regular hoodie, comfy hoodie, and just Miago Fight on the left side here, pocket, or not a pocket, but just like on the left. That would be kind of fun. Miago Fight tee? No, that's embarrassing. Gotta have a C300 wireless setup or you're not a real streamer, please. No Go XLR, bruh. I like your logo, would be solid as a simple hat shirt, etc. Yeah, something like that could be done. I do want to look into like quality materials for that stuff. I've never done anything like this for myself, so I kind of need to really look into it. I only know like cheap college stuff, like back when I used to do like custom ink orders for like clubs. You know, but I do know like if I do a shirt, it's gonna have to be like tri-blend. I'm not just gonna do all cotton. This has to be tri-blend. Tri-blend only for t-shirts. Desk pad would be sweet. I'll think about all these ideas. Desk pad. Maybe I should write some of these down. I'll do that right now, actually. Notepad. Let's see. Right. So desk pad. T-shirt. Miago Fight hoodie. And then maybe I'll put like Nano Leaf.
Stream deck. PC upgrades, which is like that stuff is gonna be a bucket list. Grails is gonna be actual upgrades.
Miagophyte pocket tea. Or pocket tea. Miagophyte on the back? Oh my god. No. No. Oh no. That makes me feel very embarrassed. Let's see, do I have any numpad keys here? I thought I did, but maybe I don't. I guess I don't. Let me get some numpad keys here. Oh, here we go. Not from last time. Comfort color blanks are absolutely the goat. I'm just gonna copy that comment and just paste it into my notepad. Oh yeah, stream transitions. Forgot to write about that. Stream scene transitions. Okay, we're just gonna test these stabs. That's all we're doing for this. Numpad keys have been used so little that they feel pretty tight. But I think the right side here is a little, the bottom here is a little. Kind of, I can hear a little bit of a tick here. Let's try this again. Miagophyte plushie, oh my god. Put Miagophyte inside a shirt pocket? That would be hilarious. You see the Miagophyte outside and then you see the Miagophyte inside? That's hilarious. Sounds pretty good. All right. Alrighty, let's solder. I jotted all these a lot of these ideas down, but I'll have to maybe I'll just copy down a bunch of these things. Come on, open up. Ideas for stream. Alright. Alrighty, let's see. Hmm.
Alright, sick. Let's go. Time to solder. Finally. Hoodie with the code, this sounds like a keyboard in Meow Go Sip. That's actually not a bad idea. Or put it like on the back part of the quote. Can you gummy mount the numpad? Good question, I'm not sure. Well, let me see, where's the No, it looks like regular top mount for the numpad. Yeah, I think the numpad is just regular top mount. Good old regular top mount. The PCB has the cutouts. Oh, I see, I see. But no, the case doesn't have any columns or anything, so no, not really. So there's nothing to support the O-ring. Let's get this going. More fan noise, and let's go. Alright. Oh, I think I read a question earlier that I feel like I didn't answer. It was something about building platelets and making sure the alignment's right. Well, I think the first tip I was going to give about that was make sure your PCB mount pins are there for your switches. And normally the plates have lines that you can follow to make sure that you have your switch perfectly straight. So I usually push the switch towards one of those guiding lines, whether it's up here, down here. Sometimes on the step caps, I try to push it to the left a little because it forces it to line up with that vertical edge, like that. So those can help make sure your switches are perfectly lined up straight without tilting. And also, you can always solder one leg and not solder the other one until you're sure that it's perfectly lined up. So that's another tip I'll give about that. I forget who asked, but it was like way back in chat, and I remember reading it, but I just realized I didn't answer the question. But yeah. So if that person's still here, that's the tip I have for making sure your plateless or half plate builds are perfectly lined up with your switches and all that. What if I want Navy's plateless? Then you're kind of fucked. Yeah. Or we can all just use step caps lock and not have this issue. That is true. Just don't support full touch caps lock. That is probably ideal. Yes, I will agree with this. You could just skip it all together, full touch caps lock. Just have one layout support on your plate,
And your plate would be for when keyless TKL, it's step caps lock, everything ANC, 7U. And then for 60% is just 7U bottom row, split right shift in my opinion, step caps lock, and probably 2U full backspace I think is a bit nicer on 60%, although some people I know really like HHKB style, so like split backspace, so maybe offer that as a separate option, but still fixed. I mean, TBH, plates are cheap to make, so, they are cheaper to make than other things, so, it's not too bad. Guys, Tommy Init now has an F18X, cool. I still don't know who Tommy Init is. What's the backstory on MeowGoFuck, Mr. Diego? It was that time when, I had, JD, when we bought JD, like as a chat, like Chad donated to buy JD from Amazon, the Amazon listing that has JD in it, like the big tiger, has some kids modeling, and that was my attempt at recreating that particular moment or that particular photograph, like the models for the like this like the models for the. Like the kid models for the stock photos of those, of the product photos for the Amazon listing had kids who really looked like they were in true agony, and I was just trying to recreate that. Split BS on 60 is a must. I like it, and I use it all the time too. Like I have HHKVs and I have other 60% boards, but I also at the same time don't quite care. Like I also use 2U full backspace on 60%, so I'm kind of ambivalent about that. So yeah, I'm not gonna give it to any of the two parties. I actually think that full backspace and could support. I mean, full backspace and split backspace support is not a problem. People have preferences on those, but on TKL, I think it should actually on anything bigger than a like anything that's 75% or bigger, in my opinion, should not have split backspace support. It just looks bad. It just looks bad because you're adding an extra key and there's nothing really to add to that extra position. And I think especially on TKL, it just doesn't look really good. That's just me though. So you know. You can agree to disagree, that's fine. I don't care. But yeah, I feel like on TKL or 75% doesn't, like split backspace kind of looks pretty shit, to be honest with you, or like anything larger. So 1800, CP, blah blah blah. If a board doesn't offer split backspace, I just assign that giant pipe as BS. Yeah, that works too. But yeah, I have no idea. This Tommy Init Minecraft kid, I honestly don't know them. Never heard of them until basically, I think last stream someone mentioned it. They were like, oh, Glars just gave Tommy Init an F18X. I was like, cool. I don't, this is the first time I hear of them, but good for them. Must be nice to be famous to get a board from Glarsis or something, you know? It's like, that's cool. Alright, should we talk about I Ain't It Watching, man? Should we talk about sponsors and what currently is on group buy? Let's do it really fast. Thank you, GZ, for the links. But you can check out all the sponsors and all the links affiliated to them. They're the vendors and folks in this wonderful community who support my channel and support my endeavors here in the hobby. They're also wonderful people. So first we have Canon keys, where currently we have a bunch of keyboards in stock actually. The Obliterated 75, the Savage 65, and the Devastating TKL I think have either A or B stock units in stock from the leftover from the recent sales that they had of these keyboards. So they are in stock, so just check the listings to see if they are in fact in stock, because I think the listings are on the front page of the website. And I haven't checked individually like which colors and which A stock, B stock are currently there, but it's worth checking if you're interested in getting a keyboard kit right now directly from Canon keys, specifically that particular line of keyboards might interest you. For sets, for GMK sets, we currently have GMK Cyrillic and beige white on black. Cyrillic beige and Cyrillic white on black, and we also have Uru macro add-on kit in beige and white on black, I believe. So those are currently available on Canon keys. And Canon keys, there's also just miscellaneous things like switches, lube, other accessories, practice 60 and 65 for example, replacement PCBs like the ANSI 60. There's also switches and stabilizers on there. A lot of people get their clip-in cherry stabilizers from Canon keys. That's one place you can get them. You can also get them from other vendors, which I'll name later, like Novel Keys and Prime Keyboard also sells. They also sell cherry clip-in stabilizers. But yeah, Canon keys is one place you can also get them too. You can also get the famous lavender switches from Canon keys as well. Just another place you can check, but Project Keyboard also sells lavender switches. But yeah, that's Canon keys. Next up we have, you can check out the panel on the right side below. If you're located in Canada, Keyspresso is offering a discount for any users who access the store using the link or providing the promo code. But basically it's a 5% off discount for any purchase that you make on keyspresso.ca. Hugo Keys was generous to offer that for anybody who is currently watching the stream and is willing to check out the website using that particular link. Next we have Mint Autumn working on Rookie Round 2 fulfillment, no other updates. Next we have novelkeys.xyz, where you can get any product with a 5% discount if it's in stock and not a group buy with the promo code Thunder. So you can use promo code Thunder on novelkeys to get any desk pads or any switches that are in stock, any key sets that are in stock with 5% off discount. You can also get Gatoron, which is the wonderful alligator plushie that's on my behind me next right in front of JD the tiger. So Ron is also you can get a 5% off for a your own edition of Ron the gator. Novel keys currently has NK65 V2s in aluminum in stock. They also have a ton of desk pads. And for key sets, we have GMK Parcel and GMK Handerbite running until the end of the month. I think Handerbite actually runs until the first week of June, so you still have some time. So there's those sets. And of course, on Novel Keys, they sell switches and lube and all kinds of different accessories that you can purchase there as well. Next, we have Omnitype, where you can purchase GMK DualShot Round 2. If you haven't checked out GMK DualShot Round 2, it has a wonderful collaboration with RamaWorks for an M6C macro pad, which looks quite amazing in fact. I am very torn on getting it, but I may not be able to afford it. It's a bit of a luxury, but I definitely am a big fan of the PlayStation console system, and DualShot is themed after that. I personally think the M6C is probably the best part of the whole drop, but the keyset itself is pretty cool. If you're into it and missed it last time, this is your chance, running until the end of the month as well. Next up we have Omnitype also has a bunch of desk pads, which you can check. They have a calendar for desk pad drops, and they also have a bunch of in stock, and they have other accessories such as mecha bags and like Tupperware for your keycap storage, for example.
Oh, thank you for answering my question about soldering playlists. No problem. No problem, no problem. Yo, Garlic, how are you, my friend? Still going? I was napping? Cool. I hope your nap was good, Jeff Leopard. How you doing, my friend? I heard you are a fan of hiney.cc products. Anyhow, next sponsor we have is Prime Keyboards, primekb.com/lightning to access the website. Over there we have a bunch of popular switches that people know, such as the Alpacas and the Cobalt Palms, which are Durock Linears. There's also TTC Bluish White and Gold Pink switches, which are new. I have not tried those, so I can't really provide a review on them, but other people might have. There's also desk keys, accessories for Topri and for MX, like the switch films and the silencing rings. There's also Durock stabs, which are the ones I use for pretty much every build I do. I always order from Prime KB for my Durock stabilizers, Durock V2 stabs. There's the Alpaca version, as well as the regular smoky black ones. There's also cherry stabilizers on Prime KB as well, if you want to purchase those instead. There's also switch pullers and lube station and other accessories that you can use for your switch modding. Prime Keyboards. No particular group buys on Prime Keyboards at the moment. Project Keyboard right now has the Sirius in palm or polycarb. It's a 60% keyboard made out of palm or in polycarb, available in different 60% configurations, in stock right now that you can check out. You can also check out Lavender switches there. They have apparel. And finally, Bingsu round 2 is coming soon. They will be opening an interest check on Geekhack for feedback from the community, but it's something for you to look forward to. They have been very positively receptive to feedback, and they will be taking other things into consideration to make sure that everybody's happy with the second run. But the second run will feature icon plus text modifiers, and the Hangul kit will be coming back, and there will also be alpha colored modifiers, which is a cool little addition compared to last time. And then we have salvin.com, where you can purchase Wilbitech PCBs that are in stock. And we also have AE Board's red linear switches over there. And we also have apparel from Salvin. So you can check those out. If you're in Europe, Salvin ships from Belgium, so it might be a convenient place for you to purchase things from if you are looking at the vendors from a European location. Finally, we have Space Cables or spaceholdings.net, where you can currently purchase GMK Deepwell, and you can also purchase different cable collaborations for the key sets that are currently running on group buy. And there's also three different desk pads. There's the SP20 desk pad, there's the Ouchkick desk pad that has been in stock for a while, and most recently we had the Bat Seed Space Cables collaboration with a quite hilarious promo video for it. Those were in stock as well, so check those out on Space Cables website, spaceholdings.net. We also have XHD BDZ in stock at Space Cables, so if you're looking for this new Krytox lubricant that's used for stabilizer wires because they adhere very well and it's very viscous, definitely recommend it for wires. I use 205 regularly, but for those who want something that's a bit more viscous for better adhesion to your stabilizer wires, XHD BDZ is a very good choice, and it most definitely works and does the job for people who are struggling with stabilizer wire lubing because it ticks or something like that. It's a better way to have a lube adhere to the spots you want it to apply. They also have lube stations, and I think that's about it from Space Cables at the moment. They will have more Stellar 65 and Stellar 12 macro pads, the acrylic kits, in stock later on. They're working on that. So more news on that if you check out their socials on Twitter, on Instagram, and Discord. You can also sign up for the newsletter, of course. Alright, Has Space Cable shipped out any of their GB cables? I'm not sure which one was the most recent one that they've shipped out, Urba Keys. I would have to check the status of that, with Space Cables, but I honestly cannot tell you because I have not entered any of the recent ones, for example. But I know that they're always working on their cables, so like it's something that they're always working on. If you do need a status update, you can probably check their Discord, but more importantly, you can always also email them and they'll be quite responsive. So it's something that you can always look into by just directly asking them what the status on the group by cables are. Anyway, is that a coaster with your character? Yeah, it's just a paper coaster with a sticker attached to it. It's just one of those sticker mule paper coasters. I've been known to appreciate miniature figurines as well. Miniature figurines are certainly very nice. I also appreciate miniature figurines quite a lot. I'm sure you know. Numpad PCB. A little less receptive to the solder. It's just the size of these things. Almost done though. Right, almost done. Okay, ooh, that joint doesn't look too good. Let's reheat that up. Okay, let's just double check all my joints. Looks pretty good. Go this one slightly. Alright, let's just double check these two. Alright, I think everything looks pretty good now. Looks good. That's some fast soldering? Was it really fast? I don't know how long it took, but I tend to kind of get in the zone when I'm doing that sponsor segment, solder segment. It's just like I just do all the let me see. Did I miss something? Streamlabs is biased? What do you mean? What happened? What happened, Garlic? Did I miss something?
Alright, we are done soldering, and we can now fully mount these guys up. Let's put it into the keyboards. Let's go. Okay. Alright. So the numpad's already here, so let's just do this one quickly. So the numpad is just top mount. So we just grab our hardware and put the screws. Made a mistake not getting the KFE. There are quite a few KFEs out there, though. Hopefully, there are a few good deals out there. I've definitely seen some pretty decent deals out there. Every so often, not all the time. So I do think that you could probably get something alright for like a decent price. Even in the aftermarket, because there are quite a few made for them. So, alright. I kind of also make myself feel like I maybe should have grabbed one of these hiney numpads, but I know that I already have other numpads that I don't really use, so I kind of figured I wouldn't buy it. Nice for collectability, but practically speaking, I already have other numpads that I don't really use on a regular basis, so I didn't get it for my own hiney TKL. But I'm a nice match, though. All right, let's open this guy up now. KFE price seem to vary a lot in the aftermarket. That's probably because there's a lot of them out there, and I think the overall perspective on them, people kind of feel like, oh, it's not limited enough, so it can't be priced too high. So I think that's kind of what it is. Let's put the bump bonds on, shall we? Where's the where did I put the hardware earlier? Oh, here it is. These have like little O-rings. There's a Hiney sticker. If you have any questions about Hineybush's products, discord.hiney.cc. There's his logo and a card that basically asks you to fully test your PCB. These are the plate mount screws. How do you like this gold color? I think it's wonderful. I think it looks fantastic. Such a nice warm color. It would look good with a lot of different things. Not as warm as me? Probably not. I definitely have had people tell me that I have like warm hands or something.
And I also get like pretty hot pretty easily, like in the sun, like in the summer. I sweat a lot too. It's actually awful. I sweat like a pig. It's horrible. I fucking hate it. It's probably one of the things I hate the most about the summer is that I sweat so much. And like it's like I sweat a lot. Ugh. Just not pretty. Not pretty at all. Alright. Okay, let's get the screws out of the way. Here is the top piece. This color over lilac. I like lilac, but I think if I were to pick a more neutral color, this gold is actually a really excellent color. Really, really nice color. From the top, has a nice fillet over here, kind of like a small lip, front lip. And the back is just softly chamfered. And then, you guys probably have seen this before, from the interior, it says not for resale on the inside. It's Hiney's logo on the left here, a bunch of screws to attach the weights. Brass weight in the inside, stainless steel on the outside. It's basically two weights stuck together by screws. But the inside's pretty simple. It's just, and then you can see the sides here. Nice curved side, very nice side profile, probably one of the nicest side profiles that I've seen recently. Very, very, very cute, very clean. All right, let's mount this guy up. We're gonna use these O-rings. So for these, you just place the O-ring into the slots. Oh man, there's like exactly the right number of O-rings. So if I lost one, I would be doomed, huh? Alright, well. And then we have our plates here. Just put it. Right on. The screws they use is aesthetic somehow. It's not much different from any of the other screws I see on other keyboards. It's just regular steel screws. It has it's Torx instead of hex, but Torx and hex are actually not that far off from each other. Like it's basically just same thing. It's just slightly different tip for the bits. And yes, this is indeed a design made by Hineybush. Yes, this is a case made by Hiney. Hiney has designed several keyboards. No, this is not his first one. He has made the HBCP. He's made this Hiney TKL1. Yeah, he's done a few other things. Alright, now screws are kind of in. Let's just tighten them to finger tight level. I don't tend to over tighten my screws, I just do finger tight. Finger tightness is more than enough. Okay, good. All done. Alright. Put the rest of the screws on. Do you think Durock clip-in stabs would make a noticeable difference versus the clip-in stabs that... What? Clip-in stabs, do you mean plate mount stabs? Is that what you mean by clip-in? Because when you say clip-in, normally when people say clip-in, it refers to PCB mount stabilizers that clip onto the PCB using these clips. As opposed to screw-ins, where you use a screw to attach the stabilizer fully. Plate mount, yeah. I think the ones on the NK65 might actually be the same ones as the Durock ones. They're just probably colored in the milkshake or whatever. Or like whatever color. I'm not sure actually what stabs are included. So I can't tell you for sure. I don't really think the difference would be huge though. Like, I can't imagine it would be very different. What keycap options do you have tonight? I have a good bunch. I'll write them down shortly. Or I'll show him shortly in the list. I need to just make sure. Pop these guys in. Alright. Perfect. Oh. Okay. Just gotta test these things out really quick. Test that out. Key tester. Okay, numpad works fine. And now the TKL. Everything seems to be working alright. Alright, cool. Alright, so keycaps available. What keycaps do we have available today? Oh, weird. Why did the... playlist stop for some reason. Alright, let's see. Keycap selection. GMK Sandstorm, please. Ooh, okay. Alright. We can do GMK Sandstorm. Yeah. The question is... Hold up. Give me 1 second just to check something. Did GMK Sandstorm have a numpad with the kits? GMK Sandstorm, was it a TKL only kit? No, it had a numpad. Okay, cool. We can do that. Alright, we can go get GMK Sandstorm. I do think GMK Sandstorm would look pretty nice, so let's go get it. BRB. I do actually need to get the board that has parts of it. So
part of my Sandstorm set is split up because I put it on my Camo Filco, and it's been here since. As you can see, that's my Camo Filco with MX Browns. All right, let's take out these keycaps. Sounds clean. So yeah, so this Camo Filco is actually, I actually modded it. The stabs are lubed. It's fully lubed, and the switches are actually lubed and filmed as well. So yeah, it's a fully modded board. Oh, I forget, closed our stabs, right? Careful. Coaster stabs though. I always forget the inconvenience of coaster stabs. A nice switch puller. Thank you, dude. I actually have a second 2.25U shift. The extension kit has it, so I'm gonna leave this shift key here. That's a bit easier. Maybe you can remove the Corby too. Alright. Oh. Looks like the did I lose an insert here? Oh yeah, I did. All right, let's get some of the other keys out here. Gonna need Numpad stuff. This guy. This guy.
Alright, I think that's all we need from here.
Is this an older board? What is? What's the keyboard on top? It's a KFEC. So not quite. It's kind of new. Relatively new. Alright, let's put these caps on now. Do we want accent enter or nah? Philco? Philco's been around for forever. Yeah. Before customs, Philcos were the grail. I mean, before customs, you just customize your own Philco. You just customize your Philco. That was the way to go about it. That was the real custom. Oh man, Sandstorm do be looking very nice on this gold color though. It looks super clean. I vote accent enter. Okay, let's do accent enter. Why not? What's the process for modding Philco? Do you have to desolder the whole thing? Well, if you want to lube the switches, yeah, you do have to desolder the whole thing. So I desoldered the whole thing, unclipped the stabs from where, so like, basically the stabs, the coaster stabs are basically clip-ons on the plate. You can like unclip them and like lube the individual parts for the coaster stabs. You have to use the coaster stabs because, you know, the PCB only supports that, right? Or rather, it's the plate that supports the stabs. Oh right, the extension kit. Yeah, and so if you want to lube the Gerald Juby, what's up? Alrighty. And let's do our numpad too. Accent enter. Probably look pretty good on it.
Oh yeah, the numb one. I forgot to put the kind of description, but it just has an aluminum plate for the numpad. Yeah, the numpad is just an aluminum plate for it. Yeah, just, you know, FYI. I was gonna do a numlock indicator, but I'll probably just do it later. It's all our time. Huh, what do I put up here? Artisans or something? Could do that. Alright. Okay, so artisans though. Bunch of stuff here. Whew. All right, let me pick some stuff here, or you guys can help me too. I have some caps here. Aha, okay. So I'm gonna pick a few things that I think are pretty good fits, pretty good matches. Maybe. And from here, I have a couple here, and this one. All right. Yeah. Oh. All right. So these are the artisans I have to pick from. How do I show you? Let's just use a lid. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're gonna choose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 caps. So there's quite a few caps here, so we're just gonna pick 5. Okay, I guess that's 13 caps here. So out of these, we're gonna pick 5. That is indeed a TPV2. How do you get that gaff? I traded for it. I traded another gaff for the gaff cap. Corby, TP, and 13. These are good picks for sure. Some people are picking these three. Popsy, maybe? We could do that. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Pick a fifth one. Just pick a fifth one. Let's just go with it. So maybe pick from 1 through 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I see 2 9s. That's enough. All right. 9, 9, 9, 9. Okay, cool. We're done. All right, so maybe we'll do, let me think about this, how am I gonna do this? Maybe I'll do a gradient here from light to dark. Yeah, so we'll do, light on the right side to dark. So maybe I'll do this. There we go.
Oh, garlic, I'm sorry. OG double shot or diceps as well? That's a lot. Stream's been long enough as it is. Alright. Let's do this, guys. Let's unplug this boy. Ugh. Nice KVD 8X and KVD pad, I know. Thank you. I got it from KVD fans. I didn't know that they were doing a gold colorway. Special edition. Alright, let's see. I guess I'll move things around a little as I type on things. Maybe I'll do typing on the TKL first, and then we can check out the numpad in just a bit. So let's open up the... Can't really tell the anode difference. Not at this angle. Oh, actually, you could probably tell the difference. Can I close up on it? It's kind of tough to tell, but it's... The numpad is basically like a single tone darker. Like a... half a step darker than the TKL. Yeah. It's a very slight difference. It's not huge though. You kind of have to look at it up close to see it. So it's actually not quite terrible. Yeah. All right. Let's try typing on this guy, shall we? Let's get a typing test up. Oh, what? Why is it not showing up? Oh, there we go. Okay, cool. Yeah, zoomed out, pretty decent match for sure. Let me turn off the fan. The AC might run in the background for a second, but I will just leave it. This is about the right distance for all my typing tests. Okay. Ooh. We're ready, right? So this is a Hiney TKL 1 with V2 Alpacas loop with 205. Film with, I think, TX films, and on a half FR4, on a half FR4 plate. So with GMK Sandstorm. So here we go. It does indeed sound like a keyboard. It does sound like a keyboard. I was going a little fast today, yeah. I was going like at 136-ish and then kind of dropped because I was making mistakes. Case foam? No case foam. No case foam on this. I'm gonna turn off the AC just in case it runs. All right. Whoa, Def want to touch the hiney just because I stood up. You're looking at my rear. Lewd. Alright. Here's the mods. Right shift sound. Whoa, that backspace sounds pretty good too. Backspace is a little misaligned, or just the angle. I think it might just be the stab,
but I can check.
Might be the angle though. I could reflow it if you think it's misaligned. It looks fine from this angle, but it's hard to say. It could just be the stab though, so I'm not sure. I could try reflowing it later. Yeah, it's like within the tolerance of the keycap, because I think it like come on, focus. Oh goddamn camera! There. So I think it like, you know, it's within the tolerance of the keycap. Keycap rotates a little. Yeah. All right. So that's what that one sounds like. Only complaint I can think of is the cable not being flush. Well, the cable not being flush is actually because most cables are made so that there is a little bit of extra distance. That's actually like the way most cables are made, because you don't want the cable to be too short and not be able to reach your peripherals. That's actually like something that I also kind of like have talked to with cable makers, and they're like, yeah, we just have a little extra slack for devices that have like ports like deep in. So you kind of have to keep that. But for a numpad, I'm not gonna do anything special. I'm just gonna like kind of type on it, like random numbers and stuff. There's a numbers test on monkey type. Oh, I guess there is, yeah. We can try it, but I mean, it's whatever. I can check it out. Oh, wait. Wait, what? What is it called? That's not it. Do you know what it's called? Fun box? I think it might be fun box. Okay. There you go. Oh, but I don't have a space key. I'll just add it to the numpad here. A space key, maybe I'll put it on. Maybe I'll put it here. Put the space there. Actually, I'll put it. Where is space? All right. Oh, sorry about that. All right. Maybe this will. This will do. Wait, what? Oh, this is the annoying part. It's because it only takes alphanumeric input from the num row, but not from, like, it's, monkey type has a weird thing where it doesn't take numpad input as for numbers. So it only takes from like alphanumeric row input, which is really annoying. All right, I reset it up, so I think it should work this time. Numlock? No, it's not. No, it's not numlock. It has nothing to do with numlock, actually. I mean, like, you know, whether numlock is on or not. Yeah. So it's a weird thing, but I remember doing this on a KBD pad one time that I built one for someone, and it was the same thing. You know. Will they do that? I don't know. All right. What's a backspace key? Okay, I'm gonna redo that. All right, so this is, that's a backspace. That's a space, okay. Whoops. That was hard. Anyway, that's what the numpad sounds like. I know that some people are super, super fast on a numpad, though. Plus key though. Ooh, artisans are good when they don't rub against the case or with each other. Those are good artisans. And also this right shift. So good. Oh yeah, anyway. Pretty good. Pretty nice sounding. Alright. good rectangle. Yeah, good rectangle with good rectangular keys and sounds. All right. There's some people who can do 100 plus words per minute on Numpad. Yeah, I've definitely seen some people who are pretty insane. Like, I actually remember, I used to do this job where, basically I was like a cashier. So I would see some people do like accounting and stuff in the background. I was like, holy crap. Some people are super, super fast with a Numpad. Sandstorm, you're a hi. Hello. How are you? It is Sandstorm though. It's getting hot though. I turn on the fan. Yeah. So here is the look of this hiney TKL in gold, sort of gold, warm, gray. No, it's more like a gold. It really is like a gold. It's such a nice color though. Here's a side. The bottom. So clean. So clean. Hey Rocklina, how are you? That's the side again. The side profile is super nice. I love the side profile of this board. It looks super, super nice. And from the back side, you can tell it's like a very clear curve here. I like the USB cutout too. Nice rectangular box to frame the USB port. I think that looks pretty nice because of the USB-C shape. Slap that butt. So this is the Numpad now. It's the Num1 Numpad. Some artisans and Sandstorm. This one's built with an aluminum plate, a full aluminum plate. Same side profile. Very, very, very nice and centered USB port, as you can see. Small little bump-ons, no weight, so nice and light. Good for work purposes, pretty clean. Yeah. Been lurking for a while doing some work. Oh, cool. Thank you for joining in. I really appreciate the company. But yeah, just one last look. 3, 2, 1. Boom. Anyway. Yeah. You guys have any other questions and stuff? This is a nice board though. We can compare with my own TKL one, I guess, which I have over here. Is a lack of badges and simplicity no branding if you know, you know, you know? Yeah, I totally agree that the branding being on the inside and nowhere to be seen on the outside is super nice on this board. Yeah, I do think that how clean it looks without the branding is really, really sweet. I actually do think it's part of the appeal of the board. So my TKL one is very different because it's a strong lilac color and it has different switches. My TKL one also has an FR4 half plate, and but it has, what did I put in it? I think I put Gateron Giants, is that right? Let me double check. Is that right? I think that's right. No, marshmallow switches. I put thick thock marshmallow switches, lubed with, I think these were lubed with 205 and TX filmed. So somewhat similar, but as far as the build is concerned. So maybe I can give you guys some comparison on that. Let me see if I can. All right. So is Alpacas. The spring swap? I don't think so. I think this is 65 gram. It's hard to do this. A bit brighter tone for the pitch. A bit brighter on the marshmallows, I think. Hard to say though. Honestly, these sound comparisons are kind of hard to, like, you know, it's not a control environment. I'm not making sure this is perfectly equidistant. It could change while it's traveling in air. So many variables, but you know. Yeah. Is it me or does your own TK1 spacebar sound kind of wet? Yeah, it kind of does. Definitely, I think these marshmallows are definitely lube, a little bit more heavily than the alpacas. I think the alpacas have a bit of a, like, a drier sound for sure. In terms of aesthetics, which would we prefer, Jaguar, TKL1, or F1? Ooh. I think aesthetics-wise, TKL1 for sure. Jaguar is pretty unique too, though. So I would put TKL1 and Jaguar on that pretty close scale. I think the F1 is nice if you want something really nice and simple looking, like kind of like very nice rectangular. It's like a wedge, right? So if you like that, like, kind of bold, sharp look, the F1 has that going for it, where it's this nice, clear-cut wedge from the side, and has these, like, you know, thick bezels on the front and back, and then thin bezels on the sides, right? I think the TKL1 and the Jaguar have bezels that are slightly more even relative to each other. Like, the top bottom is a bit more closer to the side ones. In the case of the Jaguar, I believe the bezels are actually even all throughout. So it's a different look. So it's actually, the Jaguar look is closer to, like, let's say the KFE or the Koala, where they have an even bezel, uniform bezel all throughout the perimeter of the keyboard. So yeah. How does it compare feeling typing wise compared to a different mounting styles like the F1 8X? I would say the F1 8X is a lot bouncier if you want that. I think the F1 8X is, like, pretty extreme on the side of a bouncy typing feel, like for the same form factor, because the in the case of the F1, it kind of relies on these big strips that line the top and the bottom, right? And it's like sandish in between, so it basically, there's nothing else to hold it there, so there's quite a lot of bounce. In the case of top mount is definitely much more rigid. Even if you use a half plate here, like, the alphas might be definitely a bit looser and whatnot, but I would still say that the F1 has a much bouncier, like, more, a bit more dramatic feel to it compared to, like, this top mount. How does it fare against thermal salvation? I would not make that comparison because they're two different form factors. I would not compare the way a TKL feels to the way a 60% feels, just because the size difference is enough to make like a substantial, like it kind of puts them worlds apart in a way. I would still say like the thermal and the salvation both have very bouncy feel to in typing for a 60%, right? Both have their own like appeal. I would say the thermal has that like uniform displacement sort of going on for it, where it's like it really does feel like a bit of like a trampoline. And the salvation has it's not perfectly uniform. I mean, like they're spread all across the case, but what the salvation offers you is an extreme amount of customizability, because you can use third party PCBs, third party plates. Pretty much tray mount has existed for a long time. You can just transfer builds over to a salvation with no modifications, and you can use it on the salvation, and it'll provide a different typing feel for it. So I would say that they all have their merits, right? Thermal also has a very bold look, so aesthetically speaking, personally, I think the thermal is a super aesthetically pleasing board. Very, very, very cool. But the salvation in this case offers that customizability aspect. That's kind of like the main thing going for it. I think it's like it like innovates that side of the tray mount thing. So you kind of have to give it that credit, right? I think when people say like, is this better than the other? Is A better than B? It's not a fair comparison. It's just not a fair comparison. I think comparing and saying A is better than B kind of discredits the work that they've done. I don't like to compare things like that. I don't like comparing people's work like A is better than B, because I feel like it's kind of rude, to be honest. I don't want to say something and like I feel like it's a bit rude to the person who designed it and like the amount of work they've done, and just because sometimes these comparisons are not quite one-to-one, I don't think it's quite fair. Yeah. The num one is pretty standard top mount numpad. It feels like any other top mount numpad. Nothing special. It just looks clean. It's light and simple. That's what this has going for it. It's very, very clean, very nice. Just good numpad to have around for your office work, whatever it is. That's just what this really offers. Good top mount, has it's just very clean because it's like a nice grid here. Has those four extra keys at the top if you want extra functionality, and has your regular numpad 20 key here. Was the purple build ever uploaded onto the website? I did not put, I might have put the idyllic photos, the idyllic stand photos with the TKL1. So those photos might be on the website, yes. I don't think I have a typing test of the TKL1 because I actually didn't have the time at the time when I was doing that, and I need to put it up, or I actually need to record it. But yeah, I'm happy with the marshmallows, GZ. Gotta hit the sack. Sounds good. Thank you so much, Prince Dynamite, my friend. Take care. Have a good night. It is 1 a.m. though, so. When you see other people. Wait, what? When you see other people say that salvation boards have to be expensive, I just look at the salvation and I'm like, not necessarily. That's a weird thing to say. When people say that salvation boards have to be expensive, it kind of sounds like they don't have a good frame of reference either. It's like, why do they have to be expensive? He can choose them to not be expensive, or, I mean, the price is set by the seller, and it's also time, the way they value their time and work. So kind of a weird thing to say. More like, who cares? Yeah. All right. I'm gonna move this mic here and probably let's set ourselves back up here. Sorry if like you hear like taps and weird noises. How much does the gold keyboard go for? I think if you buy it in group buy, it was, how much was it group buy wise? The hiney TKL1? I actually don't remember.
Probably over, it's like 500 plus. Can I get it now? No. No, you cannot get it now. You have to go to the aftermarket, unfortunately. The group I already ran and already shipped. Yeah, so you cannot get it right now. You can if you can convince someone to sell it to you for a decent price, but I kind of feel like people buy things to use, so they're not very keen on letting things go. Let's see, if you had to compare it with any other TKL, what would this come closest to? I don't know. I feel like the Hiney TKL one compares to any TKL that is top mount and has similar mounting positions. So I would say, like, I guess the Jane and the Whale, the Jane V2 and the Whale actually have the same mounting pose, I think. Mounting positions. You can do half play with them too, so they should type pretty similarly, actually. Same goes for, like, I think the Jane Soul, I think, also uses, like, Jane V2 plates. Koala uses Jane, like, that same mounting position, I think, and they're also top mount. So pretty much any board that has the same position, like the same structure on the inside, should feel about the same. Yeah. Keyboard is just a keyboard need. I use 3 numb ones instead of a normal keyboard? What? Just buy what you like and don't sweat what other people think, indeed. Good night, Eric. Have a very good night. Thank you so much for joining in. Everything in this hobby is expensive. I mean, well, I'm only who I am. The reality is keyboards are a luxury, right? So if you're in the hobby expecting cheap because you want a luxury, you're probably not in the right place, as in you're probably thinking of it in a way that I don't think is compatible with what the hobby is trying to, like, be or become at a certain point. Like, when people are asking for quality, you kind of have to pay for it because it just needs that much more work to make it possible. And there's quite a lot of new products out there, I feel. There's a lot of new products, new keyboard kits, in-stock things that I think weren't around years ago that we now have as options. It's just that people actually, I do think some people underappreciate some of the things that have been done for the hobby. Like, you know, entry-level 65% with QMK and VIA and USB-C and full programmability and RGB and keycaps and keyboard bags included for, like, less than $200. That was a non-existent deal. Non-existent. You would not be able to get any of that a couple years ago. Now we have it in stock. It's available. You can get it right now. You can even get 5% off if you use a promo code. But, you know, what I'm really trying to say is there is so much now compared to a few years ago that we've kind of gotten there finally. But there's still work to be done. This hobby still is undergoing growing pains. That's the reality. The demand far, you know, it goes far beyond what's available as supply, and people should just make more. Well, if it were possible, it would happen, but it's a process. You know, logistics don't just set themselves up on their own. People have to work on them. So it takes a while. The amount of value you can get from some of these newer boards is insane. Yeah. Yeah, I do think so. I personally think if I had started the hobby right now, I certainly would be happier with something that is currently available, and I think I would have stopped at an earlier point. And I think what a lot of people who have been around a hobby for a long time have in common is that they're very curious about customizing new things and trying new things out. You know why? Because those new things were not around back then, so anytime something new came out, it was like, oh, I really want to check it out. Now there's so many options that I think that actually feeds into the mentality of people asking what is the best among these 20, 40 different switches, and what is the quote-unquote best in this particular form factor now that we have like dozens of kits, you know, like named kits available from previous group buys or in the aftermarket, right? You can like choose one of these at the same price point. Like, let's say your budget is 300 or 500 US dollars, and you say, I know that I have all these different options from now until the end of the year. Which one should I get? Is normally the question people will ask me. Like, they'll ask me, like, what is the best keyboard for this budget? Or the and this form factor? And you can give them some answers, but the reality is, a lot of the products that are offered at that particular price point are pretty much almost the same, or very, very comparable, very close to each other. But like, they have those options now. Before, there wasn't that. Like, group buys were much more, which rarely happened, and if they did, they happened at lower quantities and all that. So for older folk in the hobby, I think we were always intrigued by new things, and I think that's kind of what made, for example, me stay in the hobby for a long time. It was like, oh, something new is happening. Let me try that out. And building, for me, that was the, for me, building keyboards was the way for me to try it out, because I couldn't afford to buy all the things that I wanted. And when people send in the stuff that they have, that they got, and I get to try it out, it's in a way to kind of have that experience, right? That's a benefit I get, right? I get to try things out without having to necessarily spend the money myself or owning it myself, even if it's for just a few days, whatever that is, right? Yeah. Anyway, went on a rant again, as usual. How is it? It's hot. I'm very hot right now. I'm gonna turn on the AC. Whoopsie, I totally pulled that. Sorry. It was just my cable. Alright. Oh, hot. What would you get if you were in the hobby now? TBH, if I'm in the hobby right now. If I could get used to the HHKB layout, I think like a Ramakara is probably a pretty good deal at that price point-ish. If I were looking for something fancier, I would probably just try my luck at a few raffles, like the Keycaps raffles or something, and then just call it a day after that. But, Or like, for example, if I had gotten like the Prophet or like the Thermal earlier on, and I like 60%, I would have kind of stuck with that, I think. Because those boards at group buy price were pretty fair. Or if it's something that I would get in stock, I actually like the KVD-75 quite a lot. Because I built a lot of them. I built like over a dozen of them. But I think it's a nice board. For the price. Yeah. It depends. I think I would have to set my budget again if I were to restart. Polaris is a good deal, yeah. Oh yeah, Polaris is a great deal if you had gotten that at group buy or like extras. Yeah. Thoughts on Thermal? I've said it's a very nice board. I really like the Thermal personally. All right, I'm gonna do one more typing test and then I'm gonna go. Okay. Last thing I'm doing for today. It's been like 4 hours. How about 4 more hours? How about fuck you? Streamer's so toxic. Yeah, sorry. I don't take jokes too well. Alright, let's try this. Alrighty. How do you, oh, there, okay. All right, cool. Oh, I think it's not.
Alright, here we go. Half FR heart plate and alpacas. You know what? I'm gonna enable capital letters, uppercase. How do you enable capital letters? Where's the capital letter thingy? Change mode? No. Punctuation? No. Quote length? No. How do you trigger uppercase? Oh, I guess it's fine. Yeah. All right. We'll try this instead. So you guys can hear it with the shift keys and all that stuff. Here are the mods, one more time. Anything? If you had to put some other keycaps, which one would go on well on this? Yeah, beige works. Anything with neutral colors will work on this. Neutral warm colors though. So beige, camping, sandstorm, sloth, Ursa, EPPT ivory, noir. What else has like warmer colors like that? There's a bunch. You can look them up yourself. Yeah. Numpad test? Numpad sounds like a numpad. Thing white and black would pop? Yeah, I think on this color it would look pretty. I would never put white and black on this color actually.
I actually don't like warm colors with like white and black. I think it kind of ruins the aesthetic of the warm color. It looks clean, but there's just better sets to put. So why use white and black when there are better options? Yeah. White and black is a good colorway to fall back on and to use for like darker boards in general. But for warm colors like this, don't use white and black. Use something else.
At least that's just me. Yeah, I feel like it's such a waste of this nice gold color, Anno.
Well, you have choices at your disposal too. You can always purchase an EPVT set for like 60, 70 bucks or whatever.
It's like you're blaming it on somebody else for having like more sets or something. Such a weird thing to say. Did this come in F13? No. Or at least not yet, anyway. What switches? These are alpacas. Alright. Did I miss anything? Like the direction the hobby's going? Maybe and maybe not. Partially yes and partially no. Like right now, aftermarket's stupid. People are out there to just fucking make money. So kind of sucks to see some of that. It's always been about the tinkering. Yeah, it's all about the tinkering for sure. Do agree with that part. How good do you think the gasket implementation will be for Tomo? It's going to be the same as the JMV2C. So it's meant to be a top mount board though. So I think you shouldn't worry too much. People worry too much about stuff. Trust that these people who have experience making keyboards will make a decent keyboard. I think if they've made a few good ones, I think they have an understanding of how things work. Usually can't go wrong. What Cyrillic set is that? That's EPVT. EPVT Retro Cyrillic. The one that ran through Originative and stuff, I think. I do think there's quite a few choice even as a consumer right now though. So let's see, we have a few people streaming right now. I see Max F, late night RS build. Is he really not sleeping? I thought he went live way back, 2 hours and 40 minutes ago. I see, so he's probably on the tail end. Patty's been streaming for like 5 hours, which is pretty insane. So yeah, who do we read today? Patty's a workhorse. Yeah, gotta have breakfast. Sounds good. Garlic, take care. Yo, Chumchi, thanks for the 69 bits, my friend. How does this compare to something like 7V? I don't know, because I haven't tried a 7V. Alright, let's go raid, I think we raided Max last time, didn't we? Let's go raid Patty. Let's go raid Patty. I think she's probably gonna stream for a while for some reason. I feel like she's been streaming, but she maybe might continue streaming for a while. Let's go raid Xin Xin Wang. Let's see. So next build that I have planned is, I'm actually not sure, but it might be the 7V or the Primus, the one by the one that Ilum KB ran. So I have a couple of 75% in the queue that are coming up pretty quickly soon. I still have some prep to do for those, so I'm not sure if it will be sooner. If not, I may have a personal board to build, but I'm not sure if I'm... No, I don't have those switches ready either. So I think, yeah, either the 7V or the Primus, whatever that's called, is going to be next. So we'll see a couple of 75% first. Oh, Max also raided Patty? Alright, let's just rate Patty. Double rate Patty. Let's go. But good night, friends. Thank you so much for stopping by. Again, I appreciate the questions and the active participation. Again, if you want to join my socials, I'm on Discord, Twitter, Instagram, right? So YouTube, I normally just upload my, I upload the VODs a day after or a two, a day or two after the stream, and then I upload typing tests when I publish photos. So you can expect some more of that soon. And yeah, that's all I have. But yeah, let's read Patty. Let's go read Shinchinwa. Alrighty, let's clean this up. But thank you, everybody. Have a good rest of your week. If it's hot out there where you are, I hope you tolerate the heat well, but I've been having a hard time with that. It's been ruining my sleep schedule. Wish me luck on that. I'm trying to reset a bit of my sleep. But yeah, I'll catch you guys next time. See you later this week. All right, see you all.